Cancer Project. What we've been doing here in the state of Michigan for the last 4 years is, to be quite blunt, is we've been providing cannabis oil free, basically, to cancer patients for the last 4 years on a donation basis only. This event is about so many levels, you know, not only the legal aspect and the right, but it's the patients. It's about the patients, because we have patients right now whose lives depend on this oil.
Who would think that in America it would be a crime to help someone live? We don't hide what we're doing.
What we're here to do, I'm making this very plain and simple. This is peanut butter. My name is John, aka Mark Monkey Paw. I would like to introduce some of the patients that are here right now.
Hi, my name is Laura Sherman, and I'm a 7-year cancer survivor. Breast cancer, double mastectomy, chemotherapy, and radiation. 3 years later to the day, it came back. This time it was in my lymph nodes. Did the traditional method of treatment again with chemotherapy, radiation. 3 years to the day it came back again. This time it was in my bones. Sorry. This time it was in my bones and my liver. So I started searching for miracles, and I found just some small clips on this stuff called Rick Simpson oil. I thought it was crazy. How could cannabis cure cancer? And he said that he had 100% success rate. I thought, there's no way anybody's had 100% success rate. So I started to dig even deeper. And that's when I found the Michigan Cannabis Cancer Project. And I asked for help. And John said, come here right now. Never asked me for anything in return. 3 months into the oil, went for my first PET scan, and it came back nearly complete metabolic response to the treatment. I stopped all my traditional methods of treatment and just stuck with the cannabis oil. 3 months later, I had another PET scan. This time it came back negative. There's no cancer left in my body. For the most part, I just take cannabis oil, topical oil. I don't have pain anymore. I'm working again. I'm back with my band, living life like a regular person without disease. Here I am.
The evidence is overwhelming that cannabis has medicinal value.
I believe that this holds the key to cannabis legalization nationwide, and then if the United States is legalizing cannabis, it'll become legalized globally. And before the Michigan medical marijuana campaign to get it on the ballot, we're getting signatures. At that point, I knew that there was a lot of scientific studies that showed things like cannabis killing cancer cells. For all of the noise that had been made negatively about cannabis by our government, nobody bothered to prove that it actually caused cancer. They're just making it up as they go and inventing information that's supposed to be believed by the public. It's an atrocity. It's repugnant. It's repulsive to convince the entire population of the United States that they're better off believing a lie because the government invented it for them to believe. Marijuana is one of the most valuable herbal medicines that exists on the planet.
For medicine to be effective, it needs to work hand in hand with compassion. That's the way it's been throughout history. But when you introduce politics and money, people die. It's just sad, because this should not be about money. You should not say to a person, I'm sorry, you can't afford to live.
Hello, my name is Seth Payton. I was diagnosed with a brain tumor in March of this year, 2013. I've been taking cannabis oil since about June of this year, 2013. It's now October, end of October here. It really, you know, obviously was kind of a shock. I'm only 32 years old to find out I have a brain tumor. But, you know, since I've come across the Cannabis Cancer Project, They've been more than willing to help me get this product and educate me on how it can help me. I had, like I said, I've only been taking this for a few months, so I have yet to really, you know, post any huge success with it, but I have noticed it has greatly improved my quality of sleep. Some of my symptoms, as far as when I first was diagnosed, I was very lethargic, very bedridden a lot, didn't want to do anything. You know, typically when you think of cannabis, you know, people think of a pothead, somebody who's like that, who doesn't want to do anything. But I can tell you from personal experience, after taking this oil for a while, you know, I'm not going to claim that all my symptoms have gone away, but I have improved. I've gotten a lot more energy, and now I've gotten a lot more will and motivation to actually, you know, rehabilitate my body. And all I can really say is that, you know, this is my choice to take this oil. It's not anyone else's. I'm not hurting anybody. It shouldn't be law enforcement, and it shouldn't be anybody's. It's my choice. So if I want to take this oil, who is anyone else to tell me not to if I'm not hurting anybody else? And it's only helping. And these people are doing the Cannabis Cancer Project, you know, are doing strictly donation. You know, they're not doing this to make money, to take advantage of people. These are true people that are really trying to help people. But, you know, I just implore you to really educate yourself about it, because that's what it really comes down to, is education. I mean, so many people just don't know, you know, and I think, you know, that's really what it is, and people make a lot of assumptions about things that they don't know. So I hope, you know, if you are one of those people, that you'll take the time to do your research and make your determination. So just please do that for me. Thank you.
I joined this as a peaceful warrior. Same as Gerson, the same as John. I don't have a weapon. I don't need to fight this fight with a weapon. I'll fight it with truth and rational thought and intelligence and knowledge and wisdom. Because if you divorce wisdom from knowledge, you end up with what you have in the world today, a whole bunch of knowledge that's threatening to kill us and choke us to death and suffocate us. So we need a little more practicality and common sense in our rationalizations and our realizations perceptions of life. We need to come back to natural living and realize we are still a part of nature. We are not dominant in control over nature. We are